This episode of Marijuana Today Daily is brought to you by the folks over at Extractioneering, who encourage you to be super picky about who you get your legal marijuana concentrates and extracts from. You want someone who understands the underlying science of marijuana extracts well enough to teach an undergrad course on the subject to a group of high-achieving college seniors. Don't settle for anything but the best. With Extractioneering, you know you're getting that thanks to the years of experience brought to bear by the company's head brain, Dr. Dan Hayden, a PhD biochemist with as much experience in marijuana grow rooms as in professional lab environments. Swing over to extractioneering.com to see their work for yourself, and then ask your local dispensary if they carry their products. That's spelled like engineering, but with the word extraction. Extractioneering.com. Good morning, Marijuana Nation. It's Tuesday, May 2nd, 2017, and you're tuned in to episode 237 of Marijuana Today Daily. I'm your host, Shea Gunther, and I'll be walking you through today's marijuana news and headlines. As always, we have a full and busy day of cannabis news in our hands, so let's jump right into it. Our top story of the day follows up on yesterday's top headline with a newly proposed U.S. Senate bill that protects the legal marijuana industry from prosecution by the Department of Justice being extended through September 30th as part of a larger budgetary effort. Tom Angel over at Mass Roots has a good write-up of the situation that points out one potentially worrying quirk about the story, namely that the new language extending the protections for medical marijuana does not list two states with medical marijuana programs, North Dakota and Indiana. If passed as is, federal law enforcement agents could flex their muscle in those two states against state legal marijuana providers. The compromise budget bill must be passed by the Senate and House before heading over to President Trump's desk for final sign-off. We'll follow along as this one develops. The UK's National Health Service just issued its first prescription for medical marijuana to 11-year-old Billy Caldwell, who lives with a severe epilepsy disorder that he's found relief from by the use of medical cannabis oil. Billy's mother, Charlotte, brought him to California last year to be treated with a high CBD cannabis oil that she says has greatly improved his quality of life by reducing the amount of seizures he would have from around 25 a month to less than 8. The Independent is reporting that Billy has actually been seizure-free for the last 3 months thanks to his use of the medicine. His new prescription from the NHS will allow Billy's mom to get medicine for him from a pharmaceutical startup in Dublin, Ireland, which specializes in marijuana-derived medicines. Our final top story of the day is the news that Colorado Congressman Jared Polis is hosting a small conference this week focusing on marijuana legalization at the federal level. The so-called Marijuana Big Thinker Talks will feature a number of industry experts, political leaders, professional athletes, and business executives who will chew over various topics on the politics of legal marijuana. The conference will take place this Wednesday in the Rayburn House Office Building in Washington, D.C. Swing over to Marijuana Industry News to check out the day's agenda and list of guest speakers. I see a few friends of the show on the list, including Gail Rand, Sin Hotri, and Niall Demina. As always, we have all the news we cover linked to on our website at mjtodaydaily.com and on our Twitter account at mjtodaydaily. Those are our top stories for today. It's time for Marijuana Today Daily Headlines Blitz. Before we blitz out on headlines, let's quickly thank our sponsor, Extractioneering, makers of the most sciencey legal marijuana concentrates and extracts around. If a pitcher says 1,000 words, I'll save us all a bunch of time right now and direct you over to extractioneering.com to see pictures of their work and to check out the video that was just produced by Weedmaps talking about how they approach the science, art, and craft of marijuana concentration. That's extractioneering.com, which is spelled like engineering, but with the word extraction. All right, time for the Blitz. McClatchy, D.C. published an important story about the dangers of admitting to having used marijuana in the past while crossing into the United States as an out-of-country visitor. Their story highlights a number of cases of people being denied entry into the U.S. after admitting to having used marijuana in the past, including one Vancouver man who was told that he wasn't allowed to travel to the U.S. because his admitted past use of marijuana made him guilty of committing a, quote, crime involving moral turpitude, unquote. With Canada set to legalize adult-use marijuana nationwide by next summer, things can only get stickier when it comes to cannabis and border crossings. This is a good one to click over for the full read. A proposed bill in Colorado's state legislature that would have prevented Colorado law enforcement officers from helping any outside agency from arresting state citizens for acts that are legal under the state's constitution died in committee yesterday as it was bogged down by a number of poison pill amendments. House Bill 1331 was killed by the state Senate Judiciary Committee at the request of its sponsor after poison pill amendments were made expanding the class of people protected by the law to include tourists, as well as to make it a felony for police officers to help offending outside agencies. Marijuana Business Daily's chart of the week turns its graphy gaze up to my neck of the woods up here in Maine, where it finds a booming medical marijuana industry energized by the prospects of legal adult use cannabis. Their chart shows the different annual growth rates seen in the number of patients seen by caregivers, patient certificates printed, caregiver employees, and registered caregivers, which ranged from 31% growth on the low end to 44% on the high. This is a good one to click over to see. In general, though, marijuana is hot in Maine. Alaska Dispatch News has a good write-up about the sky-high prices of marijuana in the Alaskan legal market, where cultivators can expect prices as high as $5,800 a pound compared to California, where they're lucky to land $2,000 or $3,000 for the same quality of cannabis. As my very shallow understanding of Alaska holds, things are generally more pricey up there when it comes to consumer goods, but a number of extenuating circumstances is conspiring to boost the Alaskan premium paid for legal marijuana even more. This is a great one to dive into if only to better your understanding of marijuana markets. Keeping our eyes up north for one more headline, we have the reported sales figures from the state of Alaska for the month of March showing an increase in the amount of cash brought into state coffers from taxes and fees. In all, $229,229 in marijuana taxes was paid to the state by 27 licensed cultivators in March. Alaskan legal marijuana is taxed at the cultivation level at $50 an ounce for bud and $15 an ounce for trim and shake. In all, Alaskan cultivators grew and sold 225 pounds of marijuana bud and 169 pounds of trim and shake that month. In cannabis media news, the digital media company Civilized, publishers of the cannabis-themed website of the same name, just announced that they had raised $1 million in Series A funding with plans to raise another $2 million more. Civilized is going after what they say are sophisticated marijuana consumers who are, quote, motivated and productive folks who choose to use cannabis as part of a healthy lifestyle, but not defined by it, unquote. And finally for today, we have Tom Angel nicely bookending the show with his story over at MassRoots about the admission by the National Institute on Drug Abuse that medical marijuana is helpful when it comes to reducing the rate of opioids used for pain management. A new updated page on the NIDA's website reports on a study that suggests, quote, an association between medical marijuana legalization and a reduction in overall deaths from opioid pain relievers, an effect that strengthened in each year following the implementation of legalization, unquote. Those are the headlines and news for the day. I'll be back with you again tomorrow morning with another information-packed episode of Marijuana Today Daily. But in the meantime, if you have any stories to share or feedback to give, zip us an email to headlines@mjtodaydaily.com. And while you're clicking around the interwebs, swing over to our Twitter account at mjtodaydaily and visit our website at mjtodaydaily.com to find links to all the news we cover. Before we wrap for the day, can I ask you to do me a big favor? I still need more listeners to take a few minutes to fill out our annual listener survey. If I can accomplish that this week with shorter mentions here at the end of the show, then I won't have to take up full ad spots to do it. That's a win-win for everyone. Please take a few minutes today and tell me what you think of the show. Just open up mjtodaydaily.com/survey. That's mjtodaydaily.com/survey. Thanks to our sponsor, Extractioneering, and to all of our awesome patron listeners for the support that makes this show possible. To join the illustrious ranks of the patron listeners yourself, swing over to our website at mjtodaydaily.com and click on that big blue button at the top of the page that says Become a Patron. I'm your host, Shay Gunther. Thanks for tuning in and starting your day with marijuana today. Today.
One take, Shay. One take.